I just looked at it and thought, I don't know if I can spend however many thousands of pounds on you. You're just not blowing me away. I kept being drawn to it. I kept wanting to hold it and look at it and take pictures. When I look at them from here, objectively, I think they're beautiful. Hello, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for joining me today. I want to share with you 7 luxury items that I absolutely love, but for some reason or another, I just won't buy them. There's just something about them that's holding me back from buying these. But before we do, let me share with you today's sponsor of the video, and it is Vivaia. If you have been watching me for a while, if you've watched my previous videos or follow me on Instagram on my stories, you will know that I have worked with Vivaia before and that I wear their footwear regularly. They are some of the most comfortable shoes and boots that I own. Vivaia is a company that focuses on producing design-led footwear that is not only comfortable, that is not only chic, but is entirely sustainable and made from 100% recycled products. They take their responsibilities to be responsible and to be sustainable extremely seriously. They have come up with 3D technology that allows them to produce these fashion forward comfortable designs with zero waste. What I love about their footwear is each pair of their shoes is the reincarnation of at least 6 plastic water bottles that have been recovered from our oceans. Now, I am someone who personally supports the Great Ocean Cleanup, which is a charity trying to clear the ocean of our plastics. So to find a company and to work with a company that creates footwear from plastic that has been taken from the ocean is something that I couldn't pass up. Going along with that, finding that very same company that also produced very comfortable and very fashionable design-led shoes was an absolute win-win situation for me. I have 2 pairs of shoes to share with you today. The first of these are these ones. I did have another pair. Vivaia had originally sent me 2 pairs, but unfortunately the other pair I was going to share with you are now completely and utterly sold out. They're so good, they're all gone. And that's why you may notice a few differences around here. So I'm going to share these with you instead, and I absolutely love these. I have been able to run around in these shoes and wear these shoes consistently, and they're just so comfortable. And I have found that these have worked for me as if I'm wearing sandals, as if I'm wearing something very, very neutral on my feet that goes with basically everything. These I have tried on with work type clothes, I've tried them on with cutoffs, I've tried them on with denim, I've tried them on with dresses, and they work with everything. I was worried when I first picked them, would it be in the point, would it make my foot really, really long, but I don't think they do. I think they're really, really stunning. They're the perfect summer colour, they're so light, they're going to be great in the warmer weather, and when I get a bit of a tan, these are going to be fabulous. And the second pair are from their new line that is effectively walking and running on air. And really, I show you the inside of these shoes. These have got to be... these put even the other ones to shame when you're talking about the comfort. This is like a padded, soft, spongy bed that your foot sits on. These are so comfortable. I thought when I saw the look of these that they were very Chanel-like. I can again imagine myself wearing these. Both of the pairs that I've chosen, I think I can wear to both work, which is quite a corporate type environment, and also on a more casual day-to-day basis. These, I just have Chanel vibes, and I think they're both very, very stylish. I think they're something that you will see me wearing a lot of, just like you have the boots I have, just like you have the shoes with the tigers on them. I think they're fabulous. They're a brand that I have no hesitation in supporting and working with. I love the ethos of these being made from recycled plastic. I absolutely love it. They're also a brand that want you to be happy with their purchase, so they support 30-day free global returns, so you can order with confidence. If you get them home, if they don't work for you, you don't like them, they don't fit, whatever, you can return them and get your money back, and that's something I think that's very important. They've also been kind enough to give me a discount code, which is
roses.
A discount code will get you 15% off on their website. I'm going to link their site down below in the description box, and I'm going to leave the discount code for you, so if you are shopping for any of these shoes, do go through that code and get your discount to make sure you're getting 15% off on these really fashionable, comfortable, and doing good work shoes. I love them. I love this company. Check them out and see what you think. Now, from talking about things that I do love and will buy, let's talk about 7 luxury items that I absolutely love but won't buy. And the first one of these is 2 items, and it is Cartier. It is both the Cartier Love Bracelet and the Cartier Just on Clue. Now, before you come down the screen at me, I see the beauty in them. I think they're absolutely stunning. I see them on other people with their stacks, and I think they're absolutely stunning. But there's something that's just stopping me. Whenever I was in Paris with Bestie on the first trip, we went to Cartier, and I don't know if it's because I felt the sales assistant was just trying to sell me something that didn't fit, whatever reason, when I put it on my arm, I was slightly underwhelmed. I don't know if it's because, and this was the love bracelet, I don't know if it's because it's very, very expensive. It's a very expensive gold bangle, effectively. I don't know when I put it on what I was expecting. It just underwhelmed me a bit. And I remember looking at it. Now, the one he was putting on didn't really fit. One was too tight, one was too big. It just wasn't right. It wasn't sitting right, and he was trying to sell it to me. I just looked at it and thought, I don't know if I can spend however many thousands of pounds on you. You're just not blowing me away. Even though when I think about it, I think I love it. When I see it on other people, I think I love it. The same with the Just On Clue. I put that on and I thought, there's just, it's maybe I needed to try one with diamonds. Maybe I needed more sparkle and a bigger price tag. But just something about it at this stage of my life, certainly, I just didn't love it enough to buy. I don't know if it's because it is quite expensive. Maybe if I was in a position with lots more disposable income, I would put it on and think differently. Maybe if it did have diamonds, but just something about it was holding me back and I just didn't love it enough to spend that price tag. Number two is the Dior book tote. I know. I love the prints this comes in. This is why I love this bag. The prints it comes in. This is a Dior shirt that I'm wearing and it has on it the tiger and it has the colours, and when we were buying this shirt they had the book tote in it and I kept being drawn to it. I kept wanting to hold it and look at it and take pictures with it, and they come in so many fabulous prints and colours that I just can't get myself to completely walk away from the book tote and say that won't work for you, because here's something that won't work for me in the big sizes. It won't. It doesn't go under your arm. It seems awkward. It seems boxy. I'm always going to lift the Neverfull. I just don't think it would work for me. But because of the colours and the prints that it comes in and how pretty it is, I can't seem to break the pull and the urge. But at the minute, certainly in the big sizes, as much as I love it and love those prints, oh, those colours, I'm just not buying it because I don't think it would work. And it's a lot of money for what it is. One of the ones I would be more interested in is the small version that's only about this size. That has come out in lesser prints and been harder to get. But some of the ones that I have seen online have been absolutely stunning. And I think a little handheld bag like that, I would probably use a bit like I use the Birkin. I think that would be something I would use. The big one I don't. That I haven't bought because there hasn't been one that I've seen that I've loved that has been available to order. But in all those bigger ones, as much as I love those prints, I just don't think that bag will work for me. Number three is the Hermes Oran sandals. And I know that there's a whole world of people out there that love these things, that think they're fabulous. And when I look at them from here, objectively, I think they're beautiful. I love that they come in bright colours. The tan I think would go with everything. They come in very summery colours, pinks, oranges, yellows. They come in some tri-colours, different colours. I think they're beautiful until I put them on my feet. And any time I've put them on my feet, I've just thought, you don't work. You don't look nice on my foot. Maybe it's just my foot, but I don't think suit my foot. I think I put them on and it just, again, underwhelms me. Maybe it just doesn't look right. And as much as I look at the colours and get drawn to them and want them to work, no matter how many times I try them on, even if I've had a fresh pedicure, it still doesn't work. Number four is the Chanel Classic Flap, and this is simply because of the cost. I love this bag and I'm still going on about the bright yellow one that I tried on in Dublin. I loved it so much. It was so bright. It was stunning. I had it on with a navy coat. I loved it. I really wanted to say, give me the bag. Give me the bag. Take my money. But the price is just too much now. The retail price on these is over £9,000 sterling. I think it's a lot of money anyway. And I think it was over €9,000 when I was looking at it. I just couldn't justify it. It's just too much money. I'm lucky enough and fortunate enough to have two classic flaps sitting over there. When I look at the bag, I loved it. But for the price, I just couldn't do it. I just couldn't buy one of these retail at that price. It was just too much. Number five, this one's going to be a bit controversial, I think. It's the Fendi First. There is one version of the Fendi First that I regret not buying, and it's the striped version in the multicolour. I absolutely love that bag. I love it. I think it's stunning. I think it's the colours in it. It's the print in it. I think it's beautiful. But when I've tried this bag, when I was in Fendi in Paris, they didn't have that version. Maybe if I'd had that version to try, it would have been beautiful enough that it blew me away and I would have tried that version on and thought, oh, I have to have it. But any other version I've tried on, when I try it on, If I put it crossbody, I don't like it. I don't think it's made really to be worn crossbody as much as it has a strap. I just don't think it works. When I've held it handheld, I felt a bit awkward with it. I've just struggled to see how I would use it, how I would work it into my life, how I would carry it. I've just struggled with it. I haven't saw one yet that I've tried and thought, yes, that's fabulous. And I see Merediths and I see Deals and they have fabulous versions of them. And I see their photos with them and they look amazing. Look amazing. But yet when I've held it in front of the mirror, didn't look amazing. Just didn't seem to work. Maybe I just haven't tried the right version of it. Maybe I haven't been able to see the right version that's been available in store. But so far, I really love this to look at. But I just haven't bought it because every time I've picked it up and seen it, it just, there's something about it just hasn't worked. It just, I just don't know how I'm going to work that shape or how I'm going to use it. Just not yet. Number six, and I love this, and it's the Bottega Mini Jodie bag. I think this is so cute. I've tried this on lots of times. I've went and held it and I've looked at it and I've thought, you're fab. And I've tried that really bright green that really is fab. And it just, I just think it's so cool. I just don't know where I'd use it. And it's a lot of money for a bag that I don't know where I'd use. I would have to pick it above, say, the Petite Malle or some of the other bags because it's an evening bag. Let's be honest, you carry it like this. I can't carry that around with my children or I can't fit much in it. It's only if I'm going to be going somewhere. And I have a few bags that fit that category that I can only wear when we're going somewhere that it would have to stand against and I would have to pick instead. It doesn't stop me loving it. I do still keep going to visit it, especially in that green. I don't think it's something I can say to you, I will never have one of those. Maybe if my life moves on, that my children get a bit older and I don't need to carry as much and we can go more places with them at night that doesn't need colouring books and tablets and wipes and dinosaurs and Spider-Man and all the other things that come in the backpack. Maybe I would be able to work it more then because I do think it's really cool and really fab. Just yet, I can't bring myself to buy it because I don't know how often I could use it and against those other things and just those opportunities, but it is a bag that really, really intrigues me. And finally, and I'm going to get a bit of hate for this one as well, and it is the Van Cleef. The little necklace. I generally wear my Ana Luisa thick chain and then this Louis Vuitton one and my Idyl diamonds. The only reason that they're not on at the minute is I took them off and I need my husband to put one of them back on. I can't get the clasp in. I am happy with those and they're a much more affordable price. The Van Cleef, I just think it's beautiful. Don't get me wrong. It's stunning, but it's a lot of money. And I'm told that it's semi-precious stones, which means you can't wear it in the shower. I wear the Ana Luisa one, the Idyl one and this Louis Vuitton one in the shower every day. Apart from when it's been taken off to put on maybe a statement necklace, which is why it's off at the minute, and then I need my husband to put it back on, I never take them off and they're in the shower. But I'm told the Van Cleef you can't wear in the shower, and I know me. Once I take it off, I wear hard gel on my nails. It's very hard to get the clasp on chains back in with these nails. I find it very hard anyway, so I need him to put it back on. So I can at times take something off and it takes a while to get it back on because I need him to put it back on. But once it goes back on, it stays there for ages. If I had to take off the Van Cleef every night to him put on back on the next day, I know I'm going to take it off and it's going to end up not being put back on every single day. So the fact you can't shower with it puts me off. I do think it's stunning. It's very expensive, but I do think it's very beautiful. But just the fact that it's not that durable or wearable for fine jewellery. I like my fine jewellery that never needs to come off. And I just find that a little bit off-putting to buy something at that level and that money when I know it's going to come off every day and then it's going to be a bit of a nuisance getting it back on. And I just don't know how that would work for me yet. And I think I would struggle with it and I think it wouldn't get its wear. And I don't want to buy a piece of jewellery at that amount of money that isn't going to get its wear. And that's why, as much as I love them, because I love the colours they come in, I think they're really, really pretty. That's why I haven't bought one yet, because I just don't know how wearable it would be and working into my lifestyle. So these are the 7 luxury items that I absolutely love, but for the reasons we have discussed, haven't bought yet. Maybe will buy, maybe won't buy. At the minute, haven't bought and have no immediate plans to buy. Those are the beautiful shoes that I have from Vivaia to show you. I will link their website in the description box. do check them out. They're genuinely really, really comfortable. Make sure you're getting your discount if you're shopping for any of those pieces. Thank you so much for joining me. Thank you for watching me. If you have enjoyed this, please do give it a thumbs up. Please do consider subscribing. And if you're not done with me yet, I will leave another video on the screen for you to watch and enjoy. Thank you so much for being here. Please take care, and I will see you again in the next one.